I want to establish that this is not a happy day for anybody. I have no brief for the death penalty. Now, if it were to evaporate tomorrow, it would suit me fine. On the other hand, it is a component of Georgia's law, and that's what I was sworn to uphold. That's what I've attempted to do, and I'm perfectly satisfied with it. He got a fair trial. He got a judgment by an honest jury. He got a fair outcome all around. The press has been missing. The world has been missing. The fact that a number of things, the fact principally that there is physical evidence in the case. The recantations that are so often cited are not, in fact, recantations the way the law would look upon them. As Judge Moore said in his ruling, at least two of them don't touch their trial testimony. A couple more are simply unbelievable as far as recantations go. So there's a good deal in the case that it's that the death penalty opponents have failed to bring out, and that, if I may say so, the media has failed to uncover.
When you have 7 of 9 of your eyewitnesses changing their stories, if they had done that at the time of the trial, would you have still been able to win a conviction?
If they they didn't is the important thing to know. They at the trial, they were offered every imaginable encouragement, to put it mildly, by Mr. Davis's defense, to modify or recant their immediate testimony at trial, and they didn't do it. They were under oath at the time. They were laid upon pretty heavily by the defense in the case, and they stuck by their testimony. I don't imagine that if they were all to have, what they would have done is not testified at the trial. If they were going to recant later, if they had testified at the trial that what they were saying at the trial was not true, then no, we wouldn't have convicted them. This is an important point to make, in my opinion. There are two Troy Davis cases. There is the legal case, the case in court, and the public relations case. We have consistently won the case as it's been presented in court. We have consistently lost the case as it's been presented in the public realm on TV and elsewhere. It's just been my policy, because I think my professional ethics require it, that I not comment on a pending case. And this case has been pending for 2 decades. So for 2 decades, I've maintained my silence in the case, which meant that I could never respond to what was being put out in the public relations campaign.